Hello guys, my name is Hardevinder. Today in this lesson we are going to discuss third lesson of this secondary IGCSE story, devices and media. Students, you know very well, if you are using any electronic device, whether that is your laptop, computer, this desktop computer, laptop computer, tablet, mobiles, you need storage where you can keep your things, where you keep your files, files like music files, your documents, your video files, everything, pictures, movies, system files, operating system, we need storage, storage devices. So there are two types of storage, you know, primary and secondary. Primary you have already learned in previous lessons. Primary memory means that is a temporary memory where just for a work. Primary memory is like you are a table where you keep the things just to work. After working, you keep your things in your bag or an almirah. That is your permanent storage. That is a secondary storage. So primary storage just for work, and for permanent storage we need a secondary storage. In this lesson we will discuss about the secondary storage devices. So let us start. In this chapter we are going to learn backing storage, why backup data, types of access used by secondary storage devices, types of internal and external secondary storage devices, magnetic, optical and solid state. In this lesson we will cover magnetic and optical. Solid state we will discuss in the later on. Backing up of data, why we need to back up the data. In previous lesson you learned about the primary memories known as RAM and ROM. We will consider a number of storage devices that, but first it is important to consider why we need to back up data using these devices and also how data is accessed. So you know very well why we need to back up of data. Backing of data means copying of files, data to a different mediums, disks, disk, tape, flash drive means a pen drive, etc. In case of problem with the main secondary storage device, backing up means suppose your hard disk has been crushed and you can, if you have saved your files in any other storage device, you can retrieve the things from files from there. So if you are keeping all your data on a single drive, it is a risk that your contents may lose. So in these days, maximum people keep their data on cloud computing, like on Google Drive, Sky Drive and many more different cloud computing storage is available free of cost. The people keep their things, keep their files on that cloud computing for the backup purpose. Suppose you have damaged, you have lost your mobile phones, you will lose your all files, important files saved in that mobile phone, your contact list, etc. If you have taken the backup of all these files and folders on a cloud computing, like Google Drive, Sky Drive, you can retrieve your important documents and files from there. So backing up of data is very important. So how can you take different devices, we will learn. Maximum I'll impose you to use a Sky Drive, means use a Google Drive or cloud computing. But we will learn different backing storage devices also, because the cloud computing is, according to my opinion, the cloud computing is the best backup storage media. I also, as personally also keep my things, important things on a cloud computing, because that is a very less chances of damaging the things over there. Some renowned cloud computing like Google and Microsoft, they are providing free of cost and easy. If you are keeping things there, I think our items, our videos or documents are safe there. Because before uploading this scan, whether they are attached with any virus or not. So they scan the file, then they allow you to upload. Next, why backup data? We have already so many things we have already discussed about this. Just give a view. There are various reasons why backup are made. Some of the more common reasons for are considered below: to safeguard against loss of data due to failure of original secondary storage device. This is could be due to hardware failure, for example, a head crash on a hard drive unit, problem caused by files being overwritten accidentally or otherwise, or possible corruption of files, for example, caused by power surges, safeguards against damage caused by hackers. Backups are also made in case of files need to be used elsewhere. Backup don't necessarily guard against the effect of virus. The virus could attach itself to the file, which could mean that the backups are also affected. Here I want to mention that if you are thinking that you are taking a backup of your file for keeping your file from the safe from the virus, sometimes viruses are attached with your files. When you are taking a backup, automatically that virus will go in that backup storage also. So it's not a much safeguard for that. But if you are uploading the files on a renowned Google Drive or any SkyDrive, there they check your file. They see is there any virus attached with it. They have a very strong and updated antiviruses. Firstly, they remove those drives, Google Drive or SkyDrive or any cloud computing, renowned cloud computing. Firstly, they remove the virus attached with that file. Then they upload. They allow you to upload the files. They have very good antiviruses. You can see there. I think that is a safe. But on any everywhere, it's not possible that. Suppose you are taking a file from computer to your pen drive. Your computer is affected with the virus. Automatically, that virus will go to the pen drive, and pen drive, when you will attach any elsewhere, again the virus will spread automatically. Next, it will spread out if the updated antivirus is not installed in your operating system, in your system. So this next type of access, how can you access your data? If you have saved in a secondary storage device, how can you access them? There are different ways to keep the data in a table form. You can see table is a collection of rows and columns, and the complete row is called a record, and the different columns like last name, first name, phone number, these are the fields. So this is an organized way of keeping the record of data, and this complete is called a file. There are different types of access, like serial access and direct access. Serial access, when using serial access, it's necessary to start the beginning of the file, and then suppose you want to go to a row number 6, you have to pass through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then you will reach to the 6. Here this is a serial access. In these days we are using a direct access, like CDs, hard disk, solid state drives. In earlier times we were using this magnetic tape. In this we need to go through a serial access. You can ask your forefathers or your fathers, this type of cassette, if you want to move, we have to go through all the beginning files and then you can reach to a destination. So this is a serial access. But nowadays we are using CD disk. There we can directly go to a particular location where you want to go. We don't need to go through the beginning in a serial way to reach our destination. Then direct access is used with magnetic disk, optical media, and solid state drive media. The computer uses a key field to calculate where the data should be stored in it, then able to access the data directly from the calculated position. Consequently, access the old records data are simply written over by the new records data. It is not necessary to sort records into any specific order first. So these are the direct access, like hard disk, floppy disk, now it has obsolete, and zip disks also. Maximum we are using hard disk, solid state drive, and disks, CDs and DVDs. Secondary storage media, you know very well, there are different types of secondary storage media, like magnetic, optical, and solid state drives. You know, we keep the data in bytes, kilobytes, gigabytes, terabytes. Magnetic storage media is a serial access. We have already discussed magnetic storage. Means magnetic storage includes hard disk, serial magnetic tape, hard disk, CDs, all these comes under the magnetic storage media. Magnetic storage media depend on the magnetic properties of a certain materials, iron or nickel alloys being the most common. Magnetic material is coated on a surface of a disk or a tape that can be magnetized in a such a way as to represent a ones or a zero. Many hard disk drives are made up of more than one disk, and these disks are known as platers. Each platter is made from a glass, ceramic or aluminium coated in a nickel alloy that can be magnetized. In a case of tape, plastic that is coated in a magnetic material is used to store the data. Now, fixed internal hard disk drive, you know very well, HDDs. This is a main primarily secondary storage device where you keep your record. If you see your laptop or your desktop computer, there is a hard disk in that, which is a main storage device. And next, hard disk, what are the uses to store the operating system software and working data files, storing application softwares that needs fast retrieval and store of data used in a real-time system, for example, robots, control, chemical plant, where data for the process is stored. These are the users used to fill file server and computer networks. Then advantage, they have a very fast data transfer rate and fast access time to data. They have very large memory capacities. Now, disadvantages of hard disk, it can easily be crushed, can be easily be damaged if the correct shutdown procedure is not carried out. You know, if you are not properly shutting down your computer, your system, there are many chances that your hard disk can be corrupted. This can lead to a head crash, which because there are moving disks in that. In moving state, if you are quickly, you will stop the hard disk. There are chances of this moving device be chances of damaging the things. They have many moving ports when compared to, for example, solid state drive. We will discuss in the next lesson. That is a very good as compared to hard disk. That is a very good storage media and solid state drive. Replace of hard disk, that we will discuss in the next lesson. Their read-write operations can quite noisy compared to SSDs. SSD means solid state drives. Portable hard disk, you know, these devices are very similar to hard disk, similar way of this magnetic storage device. They can be used as a backup system to prevent lost data. Advantages, the data is access time is data transfer rate is very fast. They have a large memory capacity. They can be used as a method of transferring information between the computers. They can easily be damaged if dropped. This is a portable device, you know, if it has dripped from your hand, the chances of damage of that file, that drive, this portable hard disk are more. Magnetic tape, this is a serial access, which we have already discussed. If you want to reach to a destination, you will have to go from the beginning to that particular location. So this in these days we are not using magnetic tape. In these days the magnetic tape has been replaced with a hard disk and CDs, DVDs. Advantages of magnetic disk, they are generally less expensive as compared to a hard disk. It is very robust technology, don't deteriorate very much over time. They have a huge data storage capacity. The data transfer rate is actually fast. This should not be confused with the data access time, which is very slow for a magnetic tape. So disadvantage, very slow data access time, need to read all the earlier records on the tape until required record is found. When updating another page is needed to store the final updated version, they are affected by magnetic tapes. Are storing magnet can corrupt data stored on the tape. So that's next is a optical storage device like CDs and DVDs. These are optical storage device. Earlier we have discussed the magnetic storage devices. These are optical storage devices. These are CD, DVDs, Blu-rays. Earlier we have discussed magnetic storage device. That includes hard disk, portable hard disk, and magnetic tape. And optical storage includes CDs, DVDs, and Blu-ray disc. These we will discuss in next lesson. Thank you. Thank you very much.